guys, Tiz Poopies here, and I am here with my very first Minecraft tutorial. That's right, I've never done one of these before, and I am going to do one based on all the colors in Minecraft that can be crafted and can be found in order to dye the wool, dye the sheep, dye the glass, and the stained clay. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys this in hopes of kind of trying to learn it myself, because I always forget what colors make what colors what. I always forget all the colors that can be made and how they can be made, so I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the process so you can learn along with me. And okay, so we're going to start off with bones. Bones can be gotten from these skeletons. Drop bones, and you can go ahead and take the bones and craft them into bone meal. Bone meal is basically used as a lightener of colors such as red, green, blue, and black, I believe. So these colors, if you take them, and let me get another. Can I get another black? No. It's not giving me another black, guys. Alright, so if I take red and if I go ahead and make it, I mean, combine it with bone meal, it gives me a lighter shade of red, which is pink. So that's how you get pink in the game. And if you take bone meal and you combine it with the cactus green, which I'll show you how you get those, you get a lighter shade of green. And then the same thing with the blue, you get a lighter shade of of blue, which is light blue. And we're going to need more bone meal here. We're going to need another dye as well. Ink sacks. Ink sacks are black. This is considered a black color. And if you combine it with the bone meal, you get gray. And here's another cool thing that you can do. You can take it a step further and take the gray dye and combine it with a bone meal, and you get light gray dye. So those are the colors that you can get by combining white. So this is kind of beneficial. You need to have these in order to get all those colors that we just saw. And so that's pretty much that for the bone meal. Let's see, let's get a little squid egg real quick. Squiddies, where are they? I can never figure out anything. I spend very little time in creative, so. All right, ink sacks are dropped by squid. Poor defenseless squid. When you slaughter them, you get about 1 to 3 ink sacks. And if you use a looting sword, you obviously can get more, which I always end up doing, and I don't waste time killing squid unless I have a looting sword. Cocoa beans give off the brown color right here. And they can be found in the jungle or in chests, I believe, in mine shafts or in dungeons and such. And they grow on the jungle wood right here. And you plant them like that, and you can get endless supply of cocoa beans, which you can also use to make cookies with. But for instance, you can make brown with it, but you can't lighten it too bad. All right, so let's move on. I'm going to try to rush through this so it's not too long of a video. Now, red, rose red, you can get from poppies or tulips, red tulips, and rose bushes, which the cool thing about rose bushes is, if you didn't know, some people don't. So I'm going to go ahead and just demonstrate it. If you right click with bone meal on the red rose bushes, you get more red rose bushes. And what the cool thing about these guys is that if you use any of the red flowers to make red dye, you get one per, just like that. But if you use a single rose bush, you get two, because I guess it's a bigger flower, so it gives off more dye. I think that's the concept there. But yeah, so that's how you make the red dye. For the yellow, dandelion yellow, you can also bone meal sunflowers. I always forget the name of sunflowers. And these guys, the daisies. I'm sorry, it's not a daisy, it's a dandelion. Oh my goodness gracious, I don't know my flowers. Same concept. The little flowers give off one dye, and the bigger flowers, the taller flowers, give off two dyes. Now, you can't, unfortunately, you can't bone meal the little ones and get more of them, but you can bone meal the ground, and you can get flowers that way, and you can make the grass to be too high, but you can get flowers like that, and you can multiply your selection here, and you can also get other types of flowers depending on the biome. So that's pretty much it for that. And like I said, I was going to show you guys how to get the cactus green. You get them from, that's right, cactuses. But cacti, not cactuses. Jeebus. All right. So let me try to get a cactus here. And you, I don't have anything to smelt with. If you take a cactus and you put it in a furnace and you cook it, you get cactus green. And that's the only way you can get it, because you can't really put it in your inventory just like I did with the other flowers. Why do I keep getting grass? Alright, you can't put it in a crafting table like this and get it just like you can with the flowers, but you can get it through the furnace by cooking it. And that's pretty much that. With the lapis, you find these down underground on lower levels in caves and under the ground under the earth, and when you break them, it drops a bunch of these guys, lapis lazuli, and these guys are used to dye the wool blue. So pretty much you have the basic colors here, and I'm going to go on to show you the next set of colors that you can make. Now these are all the colors that you can find naturally, pretty much. There's other colors that you can find naturally as well, but these are most common that you can either grow, kill, or get. And you can also use the white to undye your sheep or stain something white, such as, let's see, the glass over here, or this is considered white stained clay, even though it looks pinkish. But yeah, that's what you can do. All right. Well, I'm going to move on and show you the rest. Alright guys, we're here with the next set of colors that you can get, but these colors, you get them by combining them with other colors. So the primary colors that we just went over were the ones on top, and you can combine them with other colors, which I have on the second row, and get the third set of colors, which are brand new colors. And I already showed you guys the gray dye, how you get it, and it's with the black ink sack with the white bone meal, and you get the gray. And I also showed you the cactus green and the white, and you get the light green, the lime green. And these two I didn't show you because they didn't consist of white, but you get the red dye and you get the blue dye. You mix it together to get purple dye, and that's pretty cool. I love to make this color because you can also get another color from it, and I'll show you that in the next section. But blue and green make my favorite color, cyan, because I love both colors, blue and green, and they make the cyan color, and it's a wonderful combination of both. So you mix them together and you get two dyes, and you get two dyes because you're mixing two different dyes, and you get, basically they combine and give you two cyans, or two purple, or two of any other colors that you see here. So now I'm going to go ahead and show you the other set of colors that you can get, but more combinations and more types of flowers. Alright guys, we're at the last set of colors that can be crafted in the game, and these guys are special because you can either find flowers that can be crafted into these dyes, or you can craft them by combining two or more colors. I've already shown you guys the light blue, but once again, it's the lapis and the white, which is the bone meal, and you could get the light blue color. Or you can find the blue orchid, which I think can be found in the swamp biomes, and you put it in your crafting table just like the other flowers and get the light blue dye. Now you can also bone meal the ground in a swamp biome and get these flowers, because you can't you cannot get them through bone mealing the little flowers, if you remember. The light gray, you get it from the gray dye mixed with the white and the gray dye. Remember, if you combine the black and the white, you get the gray dye. And then if you add another bone meal, you get the light gray. You can also get them through azure bleu, which I cannot pronounce, and that's the way I go ahead and pronounce them, azure bleu. And also the oxeye daisy and the white tulip. Anything white, any flower, not anything white, any white flower that you find in the game will give you a light gray dye. And they give you one each because they're tiny little fellas. And then you get the orange by crafting an orange tulip in a crafting table. Not crafting an orange tulip. You find an orange tulip, you put it in the crafting table, and you get an orange dye. There, I said it. And then you can also get it by combining red and yellow in a crafting table. And that way you can get two per dye because you're mixing two colors. And I'm repeating myself over and over again, but I know it's necessary for some people, so bear with me. I'm going to skip over to the pink real quick because I've already shown you guys that one. The pink is crafted by the red and the bone meal, and you get the pink color, but you can also get them from the pink tulip and also the peony. By bone mealing the peony, you get more because it's a big flower. It's a big one. And you get two from that, but with the pink tulip, you get one. Now moving on to the magenta. Magenta's special. Very, very special. Not my very favorite color, but I love to craft magenta because it requires more than one step, more than two steps. In fact, yes, more than two steps. Because you get it by combining a pink color and a purple color. Now, a purple color, if you remember, it was the red and the blue combined together, you get purple. Well, if you combine the pink and the purple in a crafting table, now it doesn't matter where you put it, as long as they're in the same crafting table together, you get magenta. Get magenta. Magenta. It's very cool. I like saying it too. Magenta. It sounds like magical. Magenta. And you can also get them by finding alliums. Alliums I love because they're just different looking. They're like, I don't know. They kind of look like, what are those things called that you blow on and it goes everywhere? And you make a wish? It looks like those things, but pink or magenta. I don't know what they're called. I forget. I haven't played Animal Crossing in a long time. If you guys know what I'm talking about, leave it in the comments because I can't remember for anything right now. But yeah, you can also get the magenta with the lilac color or the lilac flower. And you can also bone meal the lilac out of the lilac. And because it's a too high flower, and yep, you guessed it, the allium gives you one and the lilac gives you two per. So that's the end of the tutorial. It's getting dark and we must get out of here. I cannot remember the name of those wishing flowers. Or they're not, are they dandelions? I could swear they're dandelions, but they're not, because these guys are dandelions. Do these turn into those? I don't know. It's something. Something happens to something, and then you make a wish out of it because they're special. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and go, and I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and me trying to explain myself, and I cannot explain myself. If there's any other tutorials you'd like to see me try to explain, go ahead and leave it in the comments below, and I will try my best to explain them. I can pretty much explain anything that I'm asked of. But if I'm left to my own devices, I cannot explain worth an allium. All right, I will see you guys in my Let's Plays. I hope you have a wonderful day, evening, or afternoon, whatever it may be for you. And I will see you guys later. Toodles!
you.